Dr. Blackwell, you got your MD degree in 1849, but that was not enough. You felt to practice good medicine, you needed more.
Oh, yes. After I graduated from medical school, my intention was to go to Europe, because most of the physicians that were well-trained in America did go to Europe for additional clinical training. So I was going to go to London. So I went to London, and I tried to get a post as, you know, sort of a, like an intern, and I was unsuccessful. So then I went to Paris, and I tried, and I was also unsuccessful. But I did have one offer, and it was to be a midwife student, midwifery student at La Maternité in Paris. Now, my sister Anna was in Paris at the time with me. She was absolutely outraged. She said, "You are a physician, how can you go off to midwifery school?" But I said, "Anna, this is really my only choice."
This was your opportunity, and although you did not feel respected as a physician, although you did not get the positions you set out for, you looked at what you could get and tried to make the most of it.
Absolutely. So I went there. The midwifery students were young, very young women. They were sort of a frivolous and fun-loving group. And I was able to do some teaching of them because I had my medical background. I was not accepted by the interns in the hospital. And I spent my time with the midwifery students. They worked us hard. We had a lot of clinical experience. I learned a lot. And wanting to be a surgeon, it was going to give me an opportunity to see some surgery and maybe participate.
Mm-hmm. And they set you upon your many tasks to provide care for newborn infants and to provide treatments for eye infections.
Well, that's one of the tragedies of my time in Paris. I was taking care of a newborn baby who had purulent drainage from his eyes. They were crusted over, and so I had to irrigate those eyes with a little syringe every 3 or 4 hours. And I did this. I was very careful, and I did this. But unfortunately, in the middle of the night, I was not quite as careful, I guess, and some of this pus splashed into my eye, and my eye became infected. And so what happened is then I was treated. One of the interns, Dr. Blount, was very good to me and really helped me. But I had all sorts of treatments. I had opium cloths to my forehead. I had leeches on the side of my face. I had whatever medications they tried. And then I finally really was so worried. I went to Prussia for hydrotherapy. And we sat in sitz baths during the day, and we drank all sorts of water, and we were immersed in water, and nothing worked.
And this sort of gives the listener a perspective on just how many ways medicine was being practiced in those days. It was very different from what has happened since.
We didn't have the really have the science of medicine that occurred much later.
And you had actually written that you were pledging that when you practiced medicine, you wouldn't go strictly by tradition, but rather you would measure and test what worked and adopt to your practice what seemed to work.
Well, we were beginning to learn more of a scientific method in my practice. And so, yes, I actually found many of the traditional ways of treating patients didn't work very well, and I was not going to follow them.
Right, and unfortunately, the many ways in which you were treated did not work for your eye infection either.
Right, it didn't, and so I ended up having to have my eye removed. And, you know, my dream at that time was to become a surgeon, so that quickly vanished. It was devastating. But I pulled myself up and said, "I am still a physician, I can do something." And I was able to go back to London and go to visit some of the hospitals. And that really made a difference in my career.
And it was at this point in your life that you met Florence Nightingale.
Oh, I met wonderful people in London. I Florence Nightingale, and she was from a wealthy family, and she wanted to be a nurse, and her parents thought this was not a good idea. But I learned a lot about hygiene and prevention of disease from her, rather than, in medicine, we treat disease rather than prevent it. And that would make a difference later on in my life.